Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hi guys, up till now we have studied so many oscillators and the low frequency oscillator numericals. Now this is the time to learn the numericals based on LC oscillator, that is high frequency oscillators. Now here in this particular numerical we will learn the type of LC oscillator and let's see what they ask us to find. In this particular circuit, this is again with op amp, this is capacitor, this is inductor, and this is also inductor. They have not mentioned that this is that particular type of LC oscillator, whether it is collapse, whether it is Hartley, whether it is culprits, whether it is of crystal, no, not mentioned. So you have to identify, depending on the feedback components, you can say that this is whether it Hartley, culprits, claps and whatever, so on. Let's understand, we'll decide it further. This is nothing but your amplifier, forward block amplifier with op amp, and this is nothing but the feedback, right? They ask us to find the value of RF, and these four parameters are given. L1 is given, C is given, R1 is given, and F0, that is frequency of oscillation, is given. First of all, you have to say that L1 is given, L2 is not given, right? So first of all, you have to find out the value of L2, because we will go in the reverse order. We want to find out RF, R1 is given. So if we get the value of gain, then we can easily find out the value of RF. But to have the sustained oscillation, I can say that the gain should be having that particular value, which is determined by that particular type of oscillator, right? Then once we get that particular gain, first of all, if that will be ratio of C1, C2, L1, L2, whatever. But here, one of the inductor is given, one of the inductor is not given. Then how to find out that particular inductor? Then we are reaching towards the formula for frequency of oscillation, right? So we'll start solving this particular numerical. First of all, we will say that which kind of LC oscillator is this, right? So identification we have to identify that which kind of LC oscillator is. L1 and L2, two inductors, right? Inductor ka unit Henry, Henry with H for Hartley, right? So this is your Hartley oscillator. Two inductors, so Hartley oscillator, simple. Two inductors along with parallel combination with capacitor with as a feedback circuit will forms Hartley oscillator. I know that I have identified now that Hartley oscillator is your given numerical ka oscillator. Now, by using formula of Hartley oscillator frequency for resonance, right, or also it is called as an oscillatory frequency, that is F0 is equal to 1 upon 2 pi under root of C into L1 plus L2. If we find that only one unknown is there, we can easily find out that particular unknown, provided all the values are given. F0 is given, yes, 100 kilohertz. Then 2 pi is a constant value. C is given 0.015. Then L1 is given and L2 we have to find out, right? So we'll just put the value and get the answer. You can also do that by your Calci. So check your Calci is working or not. Pause your screen and immediately come to me. The value of L2 is 168.73 millihenry. So depending on the value of L2, we will be getting the value of gain, right? So we will move further. For given operational amplifier is using with inverting configuration, so we'll be saying that A is equal to mod of A is equal to RF divided by R1. Okay, Once we decide that RF divided by R1 is A, and furthermore width by using formula for gain of amplifier for Hartley oscillator is L1 divided by L2, right? So that gain, I know that now what's the value of L1 divided by L2, right? So L1 you have to find out, L1 and L2, now both values are there with me. So we can say that L1 is 125 microhenry and L2 is about 168 millihenry, right? So just take that particular ratio of A, right? And then we'll get that particular value of A as same as the ratio of RF to R1. 0.74 milli is the gain for that particular oscillation. It's a very, very less valued. So rather than that, I will say that the value of A is equal to RF divided by R1 is 1K, which has been given, and that should be equal to 0.74 milli. Okay, so I can say that RF value is very, very less. So we'll say 0.74 ohm, right? It's a very less valued I'm getting as far as RF is considered, right? So in practical scenario, you will not find that particular value of RF. Okay, this is the answer that we are expecting. So we'll wind up here for this particular video, and we have got that particular value of RF which has been expected from the flow of the formulas based on Hartley oscillator. Thank you so much for watching this particular video. We will learn more and more numerical, we'll solve more and more numerical based on EDC oscillator. Thank you so much.